All right, so tonight I'm going to talk about the reason why deforestation is something we really have to start linking to CO2. Now, we're going to go back in history, we're going to go back to Devonian, the Devonian period, and the Carboniferous period. These are about 400 million years ago to 250. Or thereabouts. I'm not exact. Okay, now what happened is we had the Devonian, and we had very high levels of the CO2 in the Devonian, and there weren't a lot of trees at all on the planet, and there we are as fish, you know, as humans, we were as fish, you know, we were groupers, we were massive. Fish, just huge things, with tails funny and faces funny, and living underneath the water, and very few actually trundled out onto the land. The land was distinctly different. It was the land that was a land kind of smushed down by the South Pole, a lot of the continents all crammed together. Okay, so that was Devonian. So everything was just a big fish. The world was spinning faster. We had 22 hours in a day. So we were spinning faster, and we had really high CO2. And for the most part, there are studies, though, that say that there were levels of 400 going on. And they call those proxy, now this is something else, they call them proxy CO2 vote, and that's like if you go out and you take a sample of a tree ring or a sample of a ice core, those are called proxies, versus a model, a fossil model, which is another CO2. So when you're looking at all of these, the CO2 is in this era doing this or that, the proxies are often different. Okay, so bear that in mind. But yeah, they do have the 400 level still in proxy. Somebody's out there saying it anyway for the Devonian. But in reality, they were quite high. These big fish. Okay, so, and what happened? What happened is that as we had some continental, well, there was an extinction, but then as the continents divided, chunk, more continents divided, we started to have more, we were getting into Carboniferous, the trees started to just flourish. We had trees, we had ferns everywhere, forests abounding. And what happened during this time is the big, heavy, high CO2 that it was at 1,000 and 2,000 just started to dissipate and drop dramatically. And so it just swooshed into our time to 400 ppms. The trees did it. It was the trees. And the only way the Devonian, that changeover happened was because of that flourish, that filtration that took all of the the CO2, that hefty CO2, it took 1,500 CO2s away, you know, as it was, hey, bring it on, it's Carboniferous. And with that, guess what, we had more walking on the land time going on, we had more lizards on the rocks, more of the, what do we call them, alligator sizes. All of this going on, big monsters, but then now we're dogfish on the land, you know, we're loungers, of course. We have much higher oxygen level, and that was interesting also. So when you think about when you see an alligator, he really likes to be in that dense mangrove. He really likes high oxygen. He's feeling good in that moment. So here we are. Here we are now. You know, we're at this four. We're, you know, we can start saying 420 because it really is 420 in many places on the planet. Around March, when is it? March, April, May. It starts to really do that peak action. The drama is because we're deforesting, if we're taking the forests away, if we're not sustaining them, you know, we're just saying, there's a tree in my backyard, I want to cut it, because you just want to be a dumb blah. Okay, because you want to be one of those, you're a deforester, you're deforesting, deforestation, you know, that one moment, you know, where the little birds were nesting, that tree was bringing in the filter, it was bringing in CO2 takeaway, you know, it was being, hey, pretty cool, less global warming. Okay, so we get a cool off. We get a cool off with all of those. We definitely don't want to be living in Devonian. If we can just be Carboniferous, and say, hey, we wrecked the planet. We're just forced into being a bunch of alligators and crocodiles. Then that's too bad. We're gonna be that way, but we don't want to go any further because that's really hot. It's really boiling hot. We don't want to live like Adelaide and Sydney or Australia. You know how it gets to the 40 all the time, or someplace in Abu Dhabi. We don't want to be like that. We really want to not overheat the planet. So the thing is if you have a tree. Now this is something I did, because I had a tree that was undertaking my foundation of my house, and I'm like, there's no way, I can't have this silly tract home destroyed, and yet I still need the tree for the CO2 filter. And so I cut it back, and I cut the dang thing back so much that I made like a miniature bonsai of it. But it's not a bonsai, but it's a bonsai of itself. So it's now only ever going to be like 20, well, I'll say 15 feet, and then maybe 15 feet across that I can actually cut. I won't let it get any more. But I think full size it was going to be a monster, and go like this with all the silly, ridiculous stucco that they put on these houses. Yeah, the stucco and trees don't mix. I don't believe so. I don't think they do well, unless you're going to keep stuccoing over the stucco and go, well, just let it happen. Yeah, certain building techniques are not compatible with trees, whereas there's an area in Marin where they have these giant redwoods, and then they have the house right there. And the little house is just like a little tiny miniature, like where you would see a, what do you call them, a little trolls and little gnomes living and doing a little dance. And then they have these trees that are so huge that you can't even see the sky, you can't even see the sun. It's just incredible. It's just like the forest of magic in a way, you know, you go there. But that little place, those houses have to be built, you know, specifically, you know, to be compatible, you know, in that environment. And that's what we have to do. We have to be compatible with the trees, this lush, because all of this lush vegetation cleans and cleans and cleans and cleans our and filters and raises our, well, not raises, lowers our CO2. Yes, we're trying to lower that CO2. Okay. We take it all away, it raises it up. And then we end up Devonian, and then we all have to start diving into that water and just being like that with our eyes, only our eyes out. Only our eyes. Okay. I think y'all get what I was trying to say.